You keep thinking 2020 can't get worse, but it finds a way to. I watched Pati Patni or Panga, so you don't have to. Please don't. Pati Patni or Panga, streaming on MX Player, follows the story of Roman Chak, aka Romu, and Shivani, who have a whirlwind romance, get married, and then get divorced soon after. Barely 1 minute into the show and the dialogue start off with tragedy ho gaya mere bete ke saath. Pehle pata hota to badhte nahi. What is this tragedy? The show's biggest twist is that Shivani is a trans woman.
Jo meri wife hai wo shaadi se pehle wo ladka thi.
Kya bola?
How do I condense 120 minutes of mind-numbing and absolute into a small video? I mean, every episode progressively gets worse till you reach a point where your brain automatically just turns off. You know, there's a way to show homophobia and transphobia and not actually participate in it or encourage it. Like, you can show transphobia and not actually be transphobic. But it just feels like the makers of the show did the exact opposite. In all 6 episodes, the punchlines at the cost of a trans woman keep rolling, and it seems like common sense and decency have taken a hike. I mean, Romu literally throws up after thinking about having sex with a man. He constantly dreams about being with a man, and it's shown as a recurring nightmare he has to live with. And also, it just seems like they can't get the difference between a gay person and a trans person. I mean, how difficult is it to do a simple Google search when you're writing the script? This show becomes more painfully clear when you see how Adha Sharma, who plays Shivani, talks about the role in such problematic ways, saying she plays a man in the series. And at one point, when they're drinking together, he calls her choice of whiskey a ladko wala drink, and she replies, "Pehle ladka hi thi, operation karke ladki ban gaye." I mean, come on, like, what could have been a very redeeming moment in whatever the show is? It becomes a joke again. It's just casually brushed aside. It just keeps grounding Romu's feelings and actions, but we don't get to know what Shivani might be going through.
लौंडे से शादी हो गई मेरी लौंडे से.
A story allegedly about a trans woman's acceptance doesn't even show her for more than a few minutes after a point. The transphobic comment after comment is thrown her way, but she does not get to respond. You might think I'm just another liberal commie outraging over the internet on the newest thing. I mean, I am. But also, this is a very valid thing, and here's why. When it comes to shows like this and the way trans folk are characterized on scene, it does nothing to start a genuine conversation that actually goes anywhere. All witty quips aside, this could have been a very good opportunity to explore relationships that go beyond the gender binary, to step up and make a platform for people who need to be talking right now. But the makers really blew it. It's just so frustrating that there could have been a possibility to put out a really sweet, heartwarming story, especially after the year we've had. If you made the mistake of watching the show, which I hope you don't, let us know what you think about it in the comments.